with an all-out total effort by liberals everywhere, we can win in London and Middlesex County and help Pierre Elliott Trudeau sweep Canada as it's never been swept before.
All right, you're out in the comments.
I see your picture. We know you now.
How do you do, sir?
Like watching.
Are you the daughter?
No, I'm just over here.
Just to watch your home.
That's right. Thank you very much.
Hi.
Help him.
Such a scheme cost? Well, we've tried to figure it out. We've had experts look at it, and they're varying figures. Some experts suggest $1.5 billion a year. Some go as high as $2.5 or $3 billion a year. But the real answer is that no one knows how much it will cost. I wouldn't make a promise if I didn't know what it would cost. I wouldn't buy a set of long underwear if I didn't know what it would cost. This first principle will guarantee and ensure the health of liberal democracy in Canada. The people want to make sure that their rights, their values are protected. Beyond that, the quarrels between federal and provincial governments are pretty secondary. What is important is that the people be well governed by all levels of government, that the laws respect their freedoms and liberties and seek for more justice, whether they come from federal or provincial governments. It's these values we want to protect, and this is fundamental. that we are off in a terrible mess, and that things really were in a very, very difficult position for Canadians. When you hear to them, it's when you think of the kind of future they see for Canada, it's a wonder that they want the job of Prime Minister. In a sense, perhaps it's unfortunate that you should be the people to whom I'll have to give some of these figures, because they're not always exciting to hear, but they're exciting to live through, because they are figures which point to a very optimistic future for Canada. Except I do want to put them on the record. I do want to read a few of them to you. We of the Liberal Party take pride in our record of economic achievements during the past 5 years. We haven't been campaigning in this election very much on our record. We think the people of Canada are interested in the future. They know the present, they know the past, they have confidence in the future, but they want to hear the parties talk about it. Still, it's important, I think, for the record, to give you some of the facts. And it should be said that in the past 5 years of Liberal government, we have strengthened the economic foundations of our country. We've added greatly to our industrial capacity. The economy is again on the upswing. And we're very optimistic about our prospects for the remainder of 1968. And we have reasons to be, because the economic indicators tell us so. Demand for our exports is very high, and exports have been increasing rapidly in the past 6 months. As a matter of fact, during the first 3 months of 1968, they were up 14% over a year ago. Urban housing starts were up 46%. Consumer incomes are high, and retail trade is moving steadily upwards. Industrial production is rising. Canadians can look forward to a good year and to a year of expansion. Providing there are no major changes in the international conditions, which we can't always control, I expect a total increase of between 7 and 8% in our gross national product for 1968, with a healthy international payments position. Reflecting this sound economic position, both the Canadian dollar and our external payments position are strong and healthy. Robust. We've adopted before this election, and we've adopted during the election, strong fiscal and budgetary policies, which will restrict the demands we make upon the economy and which will provide leadership in the restraint that we ask Canadians to exercise on the economy. We've established as a government a ceiling on our spending during the current fiscal year, and we've even frozen the growth of the civil service. Many times during this campaign, I've repeated that our aim is to maintain a balanced budget in national accounts terms. And we don't intend to fool the people into thinking that we can forever spend more than we obtain from taxes. I think that the pollsters would have a very good indication of the way this election is going if they would attempt to judge the future of the parties by the amount of promises they make, because the less you think you're going to be elected, the more promises you make, and our parties are certainly making them. A guaranteed annual income. What we are promising in our program, and what we have repeated of this promise in both languages and in every part of the country, is that we've begun the task of constitutional revision, and perhaps it's well worthwhile pointing out that this isn't all words either, and that the parties who say that we should tackle the problem, I had been in office for 8 days when I wrote every provincial premier telling them that we were setting up the continuing committee of officials on the Constitution, and this meeting of federal and provincial officials has already taken place a couple of weeks ago. First, second, we're equally determined to provide full guarantees for the equality of the two official languages, French and English, in Canada. To achieve this, we will work with the provinces on implementing the recommendations of the first volume of the report of the Royal Commission on Bilingualism and Biculturalism. I've already indicated in other parts of this campaign that from the federal point of view, we will act with the provinces when joint action is needed, but...
gentlemen, my message to you tonight as your Liberal Union chairman is this. In the last 2 weeks of the campaign, let's leave no stone unturned. No voter not canvassed. No opportunities of any kind missed. We have a winner in Mr. Trudeau. Let's show him he has winners by helping him, and we re-elect Jim Lind in Middlesex.
Microphone. I got it.